Please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What's up, Kumpf? Today is October 5th, 2012. I'm Joey West.
And I'm Christina Honings, and it's time for your daily dose of kTV Live Eyes on the Prize.
So,
it's like Friday.
Friday.
Gonna
good.
Go into the Italian Fest?
Yeah.
Me too.
Pretty sure.
Let's get into the news.
Today we have a football team matching face off between Vin Crisafi and Vinny Sabaro and George Snell.
Today we have a football matching face-off between Vin Campbell representing the 8th grade, Vinny Sabaro representing the 7th grade, and George Snell representing the 6th grade. The goal is to match 6 NFL teams in the fastest time. First, we have Vin Campbell, and he gets off to a great start. He's crossing teams back and forth. He's almost there. And Vin Campbell finishes with a time of 8.48 seconds. Next off, we have Vinny Sabaro. Kind of an average start coming off. He's crossing off pretty fast. Oh, he hits a little speed bump. And Vinny Sabaro finishes off with 14.68 seconds. Finally, we have George Snell. And he gets off to a pretty quick start. Oh, he slows down a little bit. And with a great finish, George Snell finishes off with 26.93 seconds. Since Vin Campbell had the fastest time, he is the winner of the football matching face-off.
I knew I was going to win because my dad has cards in baseball.
Congratulations to Vinny Campbell on your earned win.
October is not only for costumes and candy corn, it is also for squirrels. October is Squirrel Awareness Month. These little woodland creatures do not only survive on acorns, but they do on salt. According to vermin.path.com, squirrels sometimes consume snow and ice because it is possibly that the salt could be deposited in these food sources. There are more than 200 squirrel species all over the world. The most common kind of squirrel is a gray squirrel.
Today's kTV birthday is famous actor Jesse Eisenberg. Jesse Eisenberg has played Mark Zuckerberg in The Social Network and Blue in Rio. According to imdb.com, he was born in New York City. His first professional show was an off-Broadway production of The Gathering. Today, Jesse turns 29 years old.
Over the summer, many new teachers were either hired or transferred at Kumpf. Natalie caught up with a new teacher, so let's pass it over to her.
Bartomaleo. She went to Kane University, and this is her first year teaching, so let's get into more on that.
Is this your first year teaching at Kumpf?
Yes, it is my first year.
What teachers do you teach with?
I teach with Mr. Taliper, Mrs. Swart, and Ms. Fetchin.
What subject are you teaching?
I teach science and language arts.
And how do you like the block periods?
I like them a lot. I'm used to block periods from other schools, and I think that it's good because reading and writing should be combined.
Miss Bartomaleo teaches in room 19, 26, and 27.
So, Nadia, you're here with the sports?
I am. But last night there wasn't a lot of sports.
Yeah, I know.
So, there was one game, and St. Louis beat Arizona 17-3. So, that was pretty good.
Doesn't really matter. No one really likes them.
But there's a lot of games coming up Sunday. There's a Giants game, so.
I'll be watching that.
So, back to sports with news.
Courtney had caught up with Miss Alexander to ask her about the new music program.
So I have Miss Alexander here to ask her a couple of questions about the new music program. So why do you like having band at the class again?
Oh, I enjoy having band as a class for the 7th and 8th graders because it's easier on the students and teachers. They don't have to miss their classes, and they could just have focus on band.
How do you like having band? Why do you think that having band as a class will improve your students' playing skills?
I think that the consistency of having band every other day is going to help them get better. They'll remember what they learned from day to day.
So, why do you think the band will do awesome this year?
We have a lot of talented students, and we're going to be playing some great songs, so I think we're going to have a good year.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Back to you.
Miss Alexander's fifth year teaching the music program at Kumpf.
Today's KTV holiday is World Teachers Day. According to 5oct.org, this holiday was created in 1994 by UNICEF. This day is to support teachers and the way they work they do to us to ensure that future generations' learning needs to meet by teachers. The motto this year is Take a Stand for Teachers. Make sure to thank your teachers for all that they do for you today.
So we have a flyer with
Courtney.
Let's pass it over to her. Flyer up. So let's, I guess, wait, we got it up, so let's go back to it.
Sorry about that. You probably couldn't hear.
But it was an awesome flyer. So
yeah, pretty good.
On Monday,
good.
We'll show it to you guys.
Yeah, guess so. So let's get back into the news.
Okay.
Now that we are getting into the swing of a new school year, the homework is starting to pile up. It may get stressful to have all of your homework done on time. Make sure to use your weekend wisely by hanging out with friends or family to relieve your worries for a bit.
It's 3 p.m. I'm steady glancing at the clock. It's almost time for the weekend. I grab my iPhone, post a status for my friends. Send a text before the day's end, cause I ain't trying to stay in.
According to ypulse.com, if you're feeling stressed while doing homework, listen to some music as you get your work done.
Fantasy football is a thing you could do with your friends. You can create your own league with friends. Which running back has the most fantasy points for the 2012 season so far? Is it A, C.J. Spiller, possibly B, Trent Richardson, maybe C, Ray Rice, or could it be D, Arian Foster? Running backs get their own points by yards and touchdowns. And the answer is C. Ray Rice with 65.10 fantasy points so far. Ray Rice played for the Rutgers in college. He joined the NFL in 2008 and has been on the team for 5 years. Here at Kumpf, we have our own fantasy league with the teachers and KTV members.
So, Julia, here with the weather?
Yeah, and it's not that... Not looking good this weekend, but
good.
Today it'll be partly cloudy with a high of 81.
That's pretty good.
But then tomorrow,
that's nice weather.
Well, yeah, but tomorrow there will be a high of 75 with some rain.
I like rain.
And then Sunday we'll have some rain and a high of 52. And Monday there will be a high of 59, but it'll be sunny. So
that's good.
Yeah,
that's
but good. It's getting colder.
All right, so.
It's the end of the show.
It's the end of the show. We don't have a preview today.
No.
So. For even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Christina Honings and the rest of KTV News team, I'm Joey West. Have a swell day.